here we are at the Marin County Fair. I'm with Jim Farley, I guess the director of this event. Tell me what you've put together here. But before we do, before we go into to you answering your question, we're standing in front of a giant solar panel that's powering a carousel. That just blows me away. Tell me about what you guys have accomplished.
Well, I'm Jim Farley, and I'm the manager of the Marin County Fair. And what you see here is the first solar-powered carousel at a county fair. Of the 3,200 fairs in North America, we're the first to take a carnival ride and power that ride, 40 jumping horses, with the sun.
That's incredible to me that that giant piece of machinery can operate off of solar panels.
Well, the story here is about energy efficiency and also solar energy. This carousel, which is a touring carousel with Butler Amusements, was retrofitted with 1,200 LED lights and a new single-phase motor to reduce the energy needs. And this is a new portable solar array. The sun comes into the panels, they go into an inverter, then they go into a battery. And this solar array can run this more efficient carousel night and day during the Marin County Fair.
Really?
That's
like just amazing to me. Night, I mean, you don't expect that from a solar panel to know that something can continue operating when the sun goes down.
Well, that's the magic of batteries and inverters, and that's also the magic of what this is, which is a portable solar array. And they're coming onto the market. I think they're going to be more popular in the future. When people are looking for energy in more remote places off the grid, it is possible to use a portable array to power a wide variety of things, including carnival rides. But don't be surprised if other county fairs across North America come up with solar carousels and other kinds of solar rides in the future. And most importantly, that they make rides more energy efficient by the use of LED lights and more efficient motor systems.
And that's just scratching the surface compared to everything else that you guys are doing here, because I'm seeing things at this fair that I have never experienced. I mean, you've got everything from organic food to tremendous amounts of education on composting, recycling, you know, self-sustaining. It's really remarkable what you guys have put together here.
Well, the solar carousel also is part of our effort to show the public and our guests to demonstrate the power of solar energy. You can't see it from here, but on that building over there, we actually have 775 solar panels and two large inverters. And actually, we generate 40% of the electricity that this fairgrounds uses on a year-round basis. We have a solar-powered stage. We also have solar panels over there for electric cars. And the idea is just to give the public the sense of the potential, possibility, and future of renewable energy, in this case, the sun.
Wow. What a great thing you guys are doing. It's just, again, it's amazing to see what you've assembled here and how you've assembled it and the lengths that you guys have gone to be as self-sufficient as possible, but more importantly, to spread that message to the fairgoers.
Well, I think it's very important. Again, there's 3,200 county fairs in North America. Last year, we became the greenest county fair on earth. This year, in addition to all the initiatives we introduced last year, we introduced a whole series of new ones, including the solar-powered carousel. We think we have a responsibility to just show the public or share with the public the future, and hopefully it's a future that's much more sustainable than the one we have now. We want to make a difference. You know, this planet faces a whole series of issues now and into the future. And I think the purpose of a county fair often can be much like a world's fair. We want to celebrate tradition, but we also want to celebrate innovation, and we also want to point out to people what the future might be, where things are headed, and give our guests a chance to look ahead to the possibilities for the future.
Well, I tell you, if there was a Nobel Prize for fairs, you guys definitely deserve it, because you're doing things that are so important, so vital to our being able to survive this planet. It's really remarkable what you're doing.
Well, actually, there is a Nobel Prize for the Fair Industry. It's called the Merrill Award.
Oh, really?
And it's given by the Western Fairs Association that serves all the fairs in the Western United States and Western Canada. And we've won the award the last 2 years in a row, in 2007 and 2008, as the top most innovative county fair among the fairs in the Western United States and Canada. So we've really raised the bar on what's possible for a county fair to do to integrate green business practices and programs into the setting of a traditional county fair. So, well, Nobel Peace Prize or what, you know.
Right.
But
The important thing is you're doing something very important.
And actually, you know, our role really is to do these things, serve as a model, and share our expertise and experience with other fairs across the United States and also internationally. That's our purpose, that's our role, is really to share and spread good ideas.
So it's like a fair laboratory at this point, where you've got these it's not experiments. I mean, you're actually doing this stuff, but it's a model for other people to use.
We've learned that we're a model. We're a very forward-thinking fair that blends innovation with tradition. And when you have the success that we've had, it's really important, and I think it's we really have a responsibility to share that expertise and give other fairs the tools to do the sorts of things, or at very least inspire other fairs to do the sorts of things that we're doing to create a more sustainable future.
Wow, awesome stuff, Jim. It's amazing. I'm so happy to be here. And again, I've never experienced a fair like this. It's just remarkable.
Well, it's our pleasure to be here, and it's our pleasure to show you around and show you what we're doing today.
Thank you very much.